I've made a copy of ODB24, and I'm calling this one ODB25IN. IN is similar to between in the way that they're both just easier ways of doing things that we've already done. And with that, I mean it's another way of filtering our result set without using greater than, less than, and equals. Let's go over into Queries and go into Design View. Let's add our table. And we will add in our last name, first name, department, and group. Let's come down here to Group in our criterion. And we want everything in Group C. If I just type in Group C, when I hit enter, it puts quotes around everything. So IN is a little trickier than some of the others, meaning we need to remember the syntax a little better. The way to properly put in IN is type in left parenthesis, single quote, then we want our value in there. We have Group C, then our right parenthesis. Pressing enter to lock that in. And I'll press F5 to run it. We see we've got 8 records in Group C. Let's modify our IN and make this, I'll need to stretch out our column. We'll make this Group C or Group B. And to add in Group B, I'm going to add a semicolon, a single quote, Group B, single quote, and press enter to lock that in. Pressing F5 to run it shows us now we've got 17 records. So IN works really well for a single value or a group of values. Let's also add in a department. We will say IN, left paren, single quote, accounting, single quote, right paren. Pressing enter to lock that in. And I'm going to stretch out that column a little more so we see it all. Pressing F5 narrows that down to 4 records. Instead of saying IN accounting, let's change this to not in accounting. Pressing enter to lock that in, and again I'm going to stretch out that column. Press F5, and we've got 11 records. So that works for character fields. What happens if we have a number, like in our hourly wage? I'll press enter to lock that in, pressing F5 to run it. So now we've got some hourly wages to look at, and we will add in left paren, 4250, that's George Wright at the top of the list, put in a space, semicolon, space, 4699, and I'll put in a right parenthesis. Pressing enter. We're adding in this hourly wage without any quotes because they're numeric values, and so far everything with numeric values does not have single quotes. Pressing F5 to run it shows us that it's bringing in just those two values. We can also change this to exclude those two values, not in 4250 or 4699. Pressing F5 brings us the opposite. Since numeric values work the same, let's add in our start date because we think that's going to work the same as well. Let's press F5 and run it. I'll pick out a start date. We'll say in 10/11/1994, right paren, enter. And it looks like this is going to work. LibreOffice Design View recognized this as a date and put the hashtags around it and reformatted the date. When I press F5, it gives us an error. We cannot use dates within. They just don't work. I'll delete this column. Pressing F5 to run it. And we will see how this looks in SQL view. I'll reformat this to make it easier to read. Our SQL looks just how we'd expect. Down at our where, I've lined up my nots and the ands, as well as our ins, and the parentheses for this. And a lot of people don't go quite this far, but we can really see how easy this is to read with things lined up. We see the department is not in accounting, the group is in group C or group B, and the hourly wage is not $42.80 or $46.99. I will save this query as ODB25 query in. Clicking OK, closing our query window, and saving our database.